Hello friends, in this video we're going to explore how you can really enhance your students' learning experiences by creating some really super simple short videos. I want to share some approaches I've used with short videos in the hope that when you use this approach you'll share with me what's worked with your students. Before I show you how I've used short videos in my teaching, let me tell you a little bit about what they are. I'll also explain why they're so useful and how you can create your own. So, what are short videos? Well, at a basic level, they're videos that are no longer than 60 seconds in length. They contain a small, focused learning experience, preferably at a really granular level. I design mine in such a way that pretty much anyone within my field or related discipline can reuse them within their own learning and teaching sessions. Let me show you an example of how I use short videos in my teaching. Here's one that I created around outlining three simple steps in starting a solution-focused therapy session. There are three steps I normally take to start a solution-focused session after explaining confidentiality boundaries. The first step is to focus on the client's strengths right from the start by asking questions such as, what do you enjoy doing? What are you good at? And what does it take to be good at that? The second step is clarifying what the client wants from coming to see you. This will set the direction of the sessions you undertake. I ask questions such as, what are your best hopes from our work together? How will you know our time together has been useful? The third step is the client describing in detail the change they want to see from our work together. This is achieved by asking questions such as, if you woke up tomorrow and your best hopes had been met, what is the first thing you would notice that is different about yourself? I would then seek more detail by asking follow-up questions such as, what else? And tell me more. This strengths-based start provides clarity and direction to allow you to help others become happier and potentially lead more successful lives. When looking at this video, I know that I could have made it much more focused by stripping away further bits of content, but this material worked for what I wanted. I do wonder, having watched this short video, what would you have removed to make it more granular and reusable? Let me know in the comments section below. When watching the video, you'll also have seen that I've embedded it within a web page. The reason for doing this is so I can add a question at the end, so that I'm able to guide the student's learning journey. We'll explore why this can be important later on in the video. Once you create your own short videos, or indeed you reuse any that already exist, you can add them into your own learning design, be that online, in class, or both. You know, a really great thing about using short videos is that you can customize the learning goals. One way to do this is that you can create your own questions to put either before or after the students watch the video. In this way, you can really start to guide their learning experiences. At the end of this video, you'll see that I've put links to some more examples of short videos I've created. Please do have a look at them and let me know what ideas they give you for creating your own. Why are these short videos so useful, and why should you start creating your own? Just imagine if, as colleagues, we all start creating these short videos. We can collaborate and potentially use them across not only different courses, but disciplines, institutions, and countries as well. What I really like is that I can use these short videos in different learning contexts. For example, getting students to access them before class as preparation material. During a class to explain concepts and trigger discussion and debate. After class so that students can use them as revision materials. Also, within a carefully crafted design, you can potentially also use them for assessment purposes. Another great advantage of using short videos is that I can also personalise a student's learning journey. For example, if they're struggling with a particular concept or approach, I can use a short video to trigger individual or group discussion. Or create an exercise where a student can be prompted to undertake further learning, for example, through research. From the feedback that students have given me, what they like about online short videos is that they can work through them at their own pace, at a time and place they feel is best for their learning. You know, I've found that the opportunities that short videos offer are only really limited by our imaginations as educators. The amazing thing I've found is that by simply changing a question before or after a student has watched the short video allows me to customize their experiences to meet their individual learning needs. It's really very powerful. So, if you haven't already rushed off to create your own short video, I'd encourage you to have a play with some of the ones I've created, even if you're from a different discipline. Just take one of the videos, there's a number of them to choose from, and simply create a learning exercise by topping and tailing a question based on what you want the student to learn. Have a go. Honestly, you'll find that by doing this yourself, you can begin to understand how simple the underlying concept of this approach is. It's really easy to create a short video. The first step is to decide on a topic. Refine the topic down to a simple idea, concept, or approach that you want to get across to the students in less than 60 seconds. For example, in the video I showed earlier, I picked three simple steps to start a solution-focused therapy session. I didn't get sidetracked by anything else, just what the student needs to know about starting a session. So in the same way, pick a small topic from your own teaching, keep in mind that it has to be created in such a way that it can be reused by other colleagues. So the subject of the video has to be very focused, preferably at a granular level. So to start, write down your script, practice presenting, get your phone out, film yourself, and then post it on somewhere like YouTube and let us know that it's there by putting a link in the comments section below. I'd love to see what you've produced. Once you've created your short video, set a context for the student by posing a question before or after the student has watched the video. And then, you know what? Challenge yourself. See how many learning activities you can build around one short video. And then share it with colleagues. See how they use it. It'll be great to hear about their ideas as well. Give it a go. Honestly, it's not that hard, and creating short videos is a great deal of fun. In the section below, I've put some links to articles that I have published about creating learning designs that you might find useful. The links to the short videos I've created are here, and I'll keep putting useful resources I come across in the section below. Talking about resources, I've also added some code in the section below that you can use to embed your short video into a learning environment like Canvas or Blackboard. I'll make a short video showing you how to use the code, and a link will appear here when it's ready. I'd be really interested to hear your thoughts about this approach and how you can potentially use it in your teaching. If you have any questions or comments, please do pop them in the comments section below. And if you happen to create some short videos of your own, please do share them. I'd love to see what you've produced. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.